Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1984, Sum All Sheets. Well, hey, I'll be podcasting the whole book. Go ahead and click that card there to subscribe to the playlist for all of these videos. Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and today we're going to talk about how to create a summary sheet. So in the past couple of podcasts, I've created these reports from January through December, and now I need to create a summary report. So I'm going to take the December report and drag it over, and I'll call it entire year. All right, and what we have to do here is we have to add up January plus February plus March. And of course, it's really tempting. It's really tempting to put an equal sign there and go click on January in that cell, plus, and then go click on February in that cell, plus, you know, and you eventually could do it, right? Although it'd be really bad if it was 52 weeks, week one through week 52. That would take forever. So there's a much faster way to go. It's called a spearing formula or a 3D reference. I'm going to show you a beautiful way to build this. We start up by typing equal sum, open parentheses. All right, now, very carefully, click on January. That was a regular click. Then, shift click on the last sheet. That's December. It starts to build the syntax up here. And then, click on the cell that we want to add up, cell B4, closing parentheses, enter, right? And what that's done is that's created a formula that's spearing through all of the sheets, adding up cell B4 on each one. Now, of course, all the sheets have to be the same shape, but in this case, since we did a fast worksheet copy, we know that that's true. A couple things here. If you take a look at the formula, they don't have any apostrophes around there. They had the apostrophes when we were building it. You have to put the apostrophes in if the sheets have a space. So January 2018, then that formula will automatically rewrite to include apostrophes around it, right? So, do the apostrophes have to be there or not? Well, it depends on what the sheet names are, but if you use the trick that I showed you, you don't have to worry about that. Now, hey, I have one bizarre difference here. This is from Bob Umlas in one of his books. He showed me this trick. Let's say that you had quarters here, Q1, Q2, Q3, and Q4, and you wanted it up only the quarterly sheets. Now, I'm just going to use anything that starts with a J instead of anything that starts with a Q. So we're going to do equal sum, open paren, apostrophe, and then what we're looking for, in my case, I'm looking for a J, asterisk. That wildcard will actually work, close the apostrophe, and then add cell B4. When I press enter, they're going to rewrite that formula and include all of the sheets that started with a J. So January, comma, June through July. Bizarre way to go. So, if you've been enjoying this free podcast series, I want to encourage you to go out and buy the whole book. It'll cover all 40 tips. You'll have a great reference guide. It's cheap. It's 25 bucks. I really appreciate it. Episode recap. All right. So, we have to total numbers on all the sheets from January through December. You could build a really long formula, but there's a faster way. It's either called a spearing formula, a 3D reference. Fast way to do this, start by typing equal sum, open paren, click on the first sheet, shift click on the last sheet, click on the cell you want, and then the closing parentheses, and press enter. Now, obviously, don't add new sheets in the middle, right? So, if you're summing January through December, don't go to August, insert a new worksheet with grocery list with 7 gallons of milk. Don't randomly take August and move it outside of December. If you go back to a great, great Model Off podcast episode, 1836, where Mac Wilk showed his favorite trick of two blank sheets, one called start, one called end. That way he knows everything between those are the ones being added up. And then Bob Umlas is a cool wild card trick that I just showed you. And again, the book, it was crowdsourced. People sent in their favorite tips. So, Othniel Dennis suggested the 3D formula references, one of his favorite tips. I want to thank him for sending it in. And I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.